Hi guys, welcome to Twitter's Funny Channel. In our last class, we saw how to load the category and brand project page. In this class, I'm going to teach how to add the records into the database table. Right now, double click on the add button. Here, I copied this coding from the brand table form. Now we can change it. Right here, insert into product. Easily you can change, go to the product, this is the product, your product, your page is this, this is your product table, these are the columns, you have to change easily. First one should be, you get like this, first one should be product, after that you have to write is description. Comma chat ID comma brand ID comma cost price comma retail price comma quantity comma barcode comma status. Right, these are the fields available in our database table. You have to write properly without spelling mistakes. You have to check it. After that, you need how many question marks? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right. 9 question mark we need. This ID column will be auto increment part. So, 9 question mark. 3, 4. Right. 9 question mark. High row return. 9 question mark. Right. Now, we have to assign the text boxes. Right. Now here, first what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to string, first one for here, this one for product, this text box name is txt pro, it's automatically generated. After that we have to change other text box as well. This one description, what's the name of this one, txt dsv, just copy control c to copy this one, and here we have to change that description. This one we have to put as dsv description. After that we have a combo box, two combo boxes, category and brand. You have to write this one instead of the id, instead of the name, you have to write database. Your ID, adding the ID. Okay, when you add the record into the database, instead of this name, it ID will be added into your database table. Okay, this ID will be added into the database table. Okay, this ID will be, if you select fan, the fan ID will be added into your database table. Okay, so what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to write like this. You have to write category item, this one, you have to get this object category item, this one, control C to copy, here you have to name this item equal, you have to bracket, you have to write like this item. Here we have to write the combo box name txt cat dot get selected item. You have to write like this. Okay. The same thing you have to write as a brand as well. Here you have to write brand item. Brand item is the name of here. I have written the brand item here. Control C to copy. Paste here brand item. This one brand item, right? That's the thing you have to write. What's there ahead? Here you have to change the text box name as brand, right? The error, what is the error? Right here we have to change this. Here the this one will be, we have to change this brand item, BR brand item, BR, right? That will be there. Okay, the same thing, right? After that, this one we put as C item. This is a brand item, right? After that, we have to write the remaining things. What are the things? Cost, price, and retail price and quantity. Those are text boxes. So we have to write string, in the string cost price, C price equal the text box name TXT cost. I think cost dot, not cost, what is the name? TXT. See this one, cost P, right? TXT cost P dot getText. You have to call the method getText, right? Out of the same thing, you have to put it as a retail price as well. Here we have to retail price, so we have to R, right? What thing you have to retail cost, retail box, what I written? The name, this one, retail P, right? After that, copy this one. We have to write the quantity and barcode and status. Quantity and barcode, status also there. So quantity we have written as quantity, I think TXT quantity, this one TXT barcode, right? That's the thing you have to write. Okay, here we have to put as TXT bar, sorry, TXT barcode. Here we have to barcode, we have to change the variable as barcode. Here we have to write as a TXT quantity, right? Here this one as a quantity, right? Now the same thing, when the user type on these text boxes, it is assigned to the variable, these variables it's assigned, right? After that, we have to set the set string here. Right, first one should be first one we have to set as a this one product. This one the product, here you have to product, you have to set. Second one description, we have to set. Control C to copy and Control V to paste. After that, we have to set the things as Control C to copy, this Control V to paste. Here I'm going to set C item. Third one, C item. You have to change it as 3. Here we have to C item dot, there will be two things. One is a name and ID. I am adding instead of the name, category name, add ID, so that I select as ID here. Okay, here we have to change it as int, set string int. Okay, that's the thing you have to do. The same thing you have to brand as well. Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. This one should be 4. Here dot ID. It's a brand ID. This one should be int. ID should be int. Right. That's the thing you have to do. Okay. When you add the record, instead of the name, ID should be added, so that the ID I am taking from here. Here. This one. Category item. I have two fields, ID and name. Okay, I have put here, this one mean ID, two mean text name. Okay, that's the thing I have called here, right? Now I have to do the another remaining stuff. You have to copy this one, Control C to copy, Control V to paste. Another thing is C price, Control C to copy. This one you have to put as 5. This one change it as string, it changed. After that, R price, this one for 6. After the quantity, put here this 7. Okay, 8 as barcode. 8. The final one status, it should be Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste here. It will be status 9 and will be status. Right, these are the fields available. Here you can check 9 fields are available. Okay, 9 fields are available. We have to check this one as well. Right, now let's check whether it is working or not. But if the red data is added or not, let me check. Here we have to put as a we have to call here product added. This message display after add the record message display product added. We have to clear the text box as well. So we here we have to clear them. This one. So after that, second one is dissenting. Third one, copy that. Third one should be this one. Combo box, Ctrl C copy. Ctrl C paste here. Third one will be the combo box, this one. Clear. Third one also the combo box. Combo box name, you have to put here. Clear them. After that, we have to the same thing. You have to write first price, retail price. After that, quantity. The final one is a barcode. Right, that's the thing we have to do. Okay, now let's check whether it's working or not. Right, all the stuff are correct. You have to check all are correct. Now let's check whether it's working or not. Product, it's working successfully. Now let's set the record as product LG. Here brand only LG available, LG mobile. Here LG is something like that. The same thing, just copy and paste it over here, like the description, something like that. And category as mobile, select as brand as LG, cost price as this, retail price as this. I am buying this quantity, barcode, so barcode. Status active, click add button. What's the wrong? Read the error. What is the error? Category item cannot be cast to product brand item. So error should be displayed here. The category function and brand function to load the category and brand. So what was the error? Here this is correct. Go here. Here the function should be wrong. The function, you have to write the brand function over here. This is the brand function you have to write. Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste here. Okay, this is not here. You have to paste to brand, new brand. Okay, that was the error. Okay, I copied the category function and paste and change it as brand, but I didn't change here. That's why the error should be there. So let's run the program and see whether now it will work. Okay, let's check. Product, let's say the product as LG something else, product description, something you can write some description. Mobile, LG, cost price, retail price, quantity, barcode, status active, click at product added. Now let's check on the database table whether it's working or not. Let's refresh it. Now here the record is added successfully. Here this is a product category ID 2, brand ID 1, these are the products, right? Now the record will be added successfully. If you have any doubt on this, you can ask me anytime. It is very easy way to add the records. You have to keep in your mind this function, how to write these functions, okay, before do the activities, right? If you like my channel, please subscribe me. Thank you for watching.